Wow, it's the most exciting time of the year coming up, Rob.
It's almost time. It's almost here.
It's almost here. It's almost time. So many winks, so many sleeps leading up to this moment. It's almost scary movie month. So, we are doing our Scary Movie Month kickoff. We just kind of wanted to get in the spirit of things right away ahead of October, just start talking about Halloween season and Scary Movie Month and what we have coming up. So, Rob, have you been, like impatient and watching anything horror or horror adjacent leading up to October?
I've been itching, I've been ready to go. I'm not
Yeah.
typically one to be itching, but because I do tend to get a little burned out by scary movies much, but I will say that I have been itching, and we'll talk a little bit about the stuff that we're gonna watch, and I'll talk a little bit about the stuff I plan to review this week. But I'm definitely getting into the horror. I'm creeping slowly to like the Ring girl. I'm creeping slowly towards scary movie month
I
with
love it.
eager creepiness.
So you're gonna come through my tube TV. But Rob, what have you been watching to take care of your itch?
Well, I'm gonna that.
I went to the library today and there's a section, and I'll send you the picture, where it's like the Just Return shelves, and they have one section that says Fantastic Franchises, and there was a copy of Boiler Room, which I think is just, I appreciate my library's wishful thinking.
So essentially, like, what we're going to be doing is, I have this coming week is The Creator, which is not a horror movie, but this will be the last sort of pre-Scary Movie Month review that I write, the new Gareth Edwards film, which I know nothing about except for that there's like a robot kid or something on the poster. So going to see that tomorrow. And we'll see how it goes. Week of October 6th, which is also my birthday.
Happy early birthday.
We've got Pet Sematary Bloodlines. I'll be
That
reviewing.
doesn't exist.
I've
That
actually
doesn't
already watched it. I can't say anything else about it, but I've already watched it. Also seeing Exorcist Believer,
Yeah.
which, okay. And
I
then,
don't we should take a beat on
all right.
Exorcist Believer.
Okay.
I don't think the trailers are bad, but
But
when I see Ellen Burstyn
yes.
show up in the trailer, all I can think of is Bow to the Legacy cast, and I immediately have my eyes roll all the way back to the back of my head, and I feel possessed myself. Possessed not to see The Exorcist Believer. I would be more interested in it if it wasn't the first of a new trilogy.
Right. That's I yeah, the fact that it got greenlit for three out the gate is distressing. That worked so well last time. The other movie that comes out that week is the only reason I'm interested in it is because Mad Men's Kiernan Shipka is the star, but Totally Killer, it's a slasher film coming out that I know very little else about. There's my cat again. Kiernan Shipka is in it, and we love little Sally Draper, so I'm going to see that.
Is that a streaming movie?
It's an Amazon Prime movie, I think. Yeah.
Doesn't exist.
So then on the 27th, at the end of the month, is Five Nights at Freddy's. I'll be looking at that too. Am I supposed to know what Five Nights at Freddy's is?
I think that it was like a game, a video game,
Okay.
or a card game, and it was basically like, what if the Showbiz Pizza Chuck E. Cheese animals go haywire and
Right.
kill kids? And I feel like this has been an idea that's been around for about 20 years and
Okay.
has been the subject of many a short films and Willy's Wonderland. And it feels very passe at this point. And Josh Hutcherson's in it. And I'm sorry, I can't muster up any enthusiasm. There is a horror movie coming out on October 20th. I'm really excited about. I don't know much about it, but it's called Killers of the Flower Moon.
Oh, that's right. That's got a killer in the title.
Yeah, so I think that counts.
It's gonna be horror.
Yeah. And then there's like a scary concert movie coming out on Friday the 13th, so I think that counts. It's about Travis Kelce's girlfriend.
Excuse me. we're not ready to commit to this punk just yet, all right? So maybe we're not like super excited about what's coming to theaters, but there are movies that have been on the stack. Every scary movie, they're on the stack, ages you never get to them, right? They're at the bottom of the
Sometimes
stack.
for years.
Sometimes, and they just like you're like you put it there every year, and you're like, I don't know, So Adam, I know you've got a couple of movies on the stack that you swear you're gonna watch this year.
I've got a bunch. So I've got from my Val Lewton collection, this is a double feature of Isle of the Dead, which I've seen, but I've never seen Bedlam. So I'm gonna watch Bedlam starring Boris Karloff. I'm a big fan of the Val Lewton, Jacques Tenniere, classy horror movies of the 60s. So I'll watch that. I'm going to watch Gothica for its 20-year anniversary. I've never seen that. I have seen the Fred Durst music video from the movie with Halle Berry, I believe, in a water tank or a glass cage.
Sure.
It's one of the few Dark Castle movies I haven't seen. I'm finally going to watch Tobe Hooper's Eaten Alive.
Hey, there you go.
I will not throw that one.
Throw that one. What if you threw it and I, if we had prepared this bit better and you had mailed me a bunch of stuff and you threw it and I caught it? Wouldn't that have been amazing?
Next year,
Scary
next
movie
year.
month magic.
Then this is a movie that Patrick has gifted to me, Dead Heat, starring Joe Piscopo and the late great Treat Williams and
Yes.
Vincent Price. Gotta see that. And then I don't have my expectations set very high on this one, but the Frank Darabont made for TV movie Buried Alive with Jennifer Jason Leigh and William Atherton. So those are five that I definitely plan on getting to at some point in October.
I, on the other hand, am garbage at this. I am bad at coming up with lists. I used to meticulously plan. We've talked about this in Scary Movie months past. I would do all new to me. I would do lots of different things. So I came up with a foolproof plan this year. Okay. I found a website that will give you one of those little picker wheels. I know it's hard to see on my phone, but one of those little spinny wheels, right? And so what I've decided to do is I made a little spinny wheel with all the streaming services on it. And what I'm going to do is when it comes time to watch a movie for a Scary Movie Month, I'm going to spin the wheel. I just hit it. You can't see it, but I just hit it. And whichever streaming service it lands on, I'm going to find a horror movie to watch on that streaming service. So that's going to be my game this Scary Movie Month.
But then you get to the streaming service and you're still going to have the thing where you have to search around for like an hour to find
Well,
a movie.
that's true, but at least I'm limited in my criteria in terms of like, I for me it's always just kind of I don't have, like I said before, I don't have a ton of goals when it comes to what I want to accomplish for Scary Movie Month. So I think the fun of it will just be digging around the streaming service looking to see what they got on there.
So that's a good segue. Why don't we talk about some of the stuff that we've got planned for either reserve seating or just for our writing or podcast this month? Rob, what do you got cooking?
So, like I said already, I'm going to review a few of the movies that I talked about before. I'm also going to be joining Patrick this month for a podcast on Underwater, which
Nice.
I know I've been singing the praises of Brian Duffield's new film. Wow. I know I've been singing the praises of Brian Duffield's new film, No One Will Save You, and this was totally unplanned. Patrick and I talked last time about doing Underwater for Scary Movie Month. It just so happens that the screenwriter of Underwater has an amazing new movie out. I've always been a huge fan of Underwater. I think it's a totally underrated movie, and I can't wait to talk about it for this Scary Movie Month.
So I am going to be doing a podcast with Patrick on Urban Legend, for its 25th anniversary. So I'll finally get to see Urban Legend's final cut, which I've never watched. So that'll be good. The show's not on both, but I'm sure we'll talk about both. And then I plan on doing a couple of articles on Cabin Fever and Freddy versus Jason. And then we have some fun stuff planned over the next 3 weeks. So next week we are going to be doing a double feature of new metal horror movies, Resident Evil and Book of Shadows, Blair Witch 2. And then we will follow that up with a special edition of Mean Jeans called Halloween Jeans, where we talk about horror movies that Gene Siskel panned. over the years and if we agree with that or not. And then, of course, we've been teasing it for months, To Be Halloween with special guest Dana Buckler. So all of those we're really excited about. We hope you will join us for those too. I'm thinking about renting a theater to play Wishmaster, but I'm afraid that nobody will show up. So the thing that I'm mentioning here, because I want to tee it up over our F This Movie community, is write in the comments if you would go if I say opened it up to the F This Movie fandom and said, hey, it's a free screening of Wishmaster. All you have to do is show up and let me know that you're coming and I'll write you down on a list. So if we get enough people who want to do that, I'll rent a theater. If not, I'll watch it at home.
Will
Yeah.
you be watching Wishmaster 4?
No.
Then I'm not.
One. So I've got some fun stuff planned. I'm gonna go see a screening of The Crow at the Music Box, and Biling will be there. So that'll be fun. I'm finally gonna get to see Hocus Pocus and Carnival of Souls in a movie theater. So I'm very excited
Nice.
about that. I am going to the Music Box of Horrors for part of it, which is a tradition. I'll write about that as well. I want to go to a Halloween carnival. I want to go to the farmer's market and buy some cider donuts and some kettle corn. It's all happening. It's all happening. And then speaking of the Music Box of Horror or Music Box, I just want to give a shout out to I got in the festive mood this weekend and I went to see Night of the Living Dead in 35 millimeter and it
Ooh.
was really cool. But a really weird thing only at the Music Box happened. And I love the Music Box, so this is not me bashing the Music Box, but it was really weird. So the movie ends, spoilers for Night of the Living Dead. Ben dies. Then they show like a series, a montage of still photographs that are supposed to really hammer home the social commentary of the movie. Of the theater filled with maybe 500 people, about 200 of them got up at the first end credit and was like, well, I came here, I got what I came here for, and walked out during the montage of still images. And I thought that that was really weird. Thank you everybody for joining us. We want to hear what you have planned. What movies are you excited about watching? What are you going to watch for the first time? What festivities do you have? What are you looking forward to about the Scary Movie Month season? Leave a comment. Let us know.
What if I covered this whole thing in pumpkin spice? What if this
Do it.
was pumpkin spice flavored back here?
Do it.
What if I got a ghost? What if I got a little skeleton?
So until next time.
These seats. Spooky.
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 Pumpkin spice.
Well, they will be next time. They're not spooky yet. It's still September.
I'm the laziest ass ghost ever. All I can think of is doing this. Like I'm typing, like I'm a clerical ghost.